Cluster 34, our home. Prosperity. Liberty.
上午好啊。
Democracy. Our way of life.
吃饭了吗？
But your loot doesn't come free. No, sweet red cream. No! Look familiar? Scenes like these are happening all over the DMZ right now. You could be next. That is, unless you make the most important decision of your life. Prove to yourself you have the strength and courage to be free. Join the Rift Runners. Become an elite pilot in Rockfish Games Discord.See exotic new life forms. And spread your overpowered ship builds throughout the community. Become a pro. Become a legend. Become a Rift Runner. Hello, Rift Runners, Wizard Jerry here. Welcome to the 7th DMZ Dogfight Competition. It has been about 2 months since Titan's DLC released, and we have received a bunch of new items. Because the lunacy cap is still 2000, these new items will certainly help us to clear the rift with a faster and more entertaining way. And I will probably say, these new catalysts can bring more benefits than those new items during the rift. So if you want to try a new build with new items, but you are unsure if they are better, I would suggest you install those new catalysts and just go for it. But since you are watching this video, well, as usual, I will recommend each ship with a powerful build that's suitable for speedrunning the Lunacy 2000 Rift. Because this video is also being submitted to Bilibili, most of the UI will be in Chinese.However, I have included all the build's detail in English in the summary section in the very end of the video, so hopefully this can make more sense. Before we start, again, these 4 Titans items are very frequently used in this video, so make sure you can find them during farming.You may just notice that I didn't recommend any Titan weapons, so this means most ships' playstyle and build remain almost unchanged compared with my last video. So this time I may spend less time explaining some basics because I may assume you guys have already watched the previous one. But if you really got a question like, oh, why are you using this or that, feel free to leave a comment below.I also need to mention one more thing. Since I have been really busy in real life, I had to save some time on recording the video. You know, as a PhD student, you are not supposed to spend 10 hours per day on Everspace, right? So I record the build showcase and the real combat parts separately. This means if I am not satisfied with the combat, I will stop recording and I load the Rift autosave and start recording again. This certainly saves some time for sure because I don't have to show my build one more time. However, this will lead to an unexpected bug, which is the first wave of enemies in stage 1. You can see some of them got an initial hit point reduction, like this outlaw bomber. But this bug will not affect any following enemies, so I can assure you all these builds in the video are still performing as intended. Alright, let's take a look at the ship's passive and paint job first, and then let's get started.
Lord Brother, at long last you are returned.
はじめまして。僕は第4ドール創生石。あなたが僕のマスター？
期待難は、T K6821 搭乗員エド少尉は速やかに覚醒されたし。
はじめまして、イザヨイサクヤですわ。
愛と死は音楽にとって永遠のテーマ。
既然你都求我了，那帮帮你也可以呀。
It's like a tradition in my video series to let Bomber to go first. Speaking of the change of the build, we switch Red Booster to Quantum Turbo and Cargo Unit to XR's Ingenuity. Then apply Evolution Catalyst on those mines, and that is. Obviously, Bomber can deal even more damage after this DLC update, not only due to the 15% increased mine damage from XR's Ingenuity, but also the Evolution Catalyst can potentially break the exclusive and provide you one more faction damage bonus attribute, even you have one faction attribute on your weapon already. I think that's enough for the Bomber. To be honest, this build has been very completed since 1.0 release last year, and now we are just making some minor tweaks and adjustments based on it. Overall, the Bomber is still a great ship to pilot, and it is also the one I would personally recommend to players new to the Ancient Rifts. However, as a heavy ship, its mobility remains an issue. Also, while you are destroying enemies faster and faster, maintaining your ultimate charge below 60% with devotion is becoming more challenging.The build for Sentinel didn't change too much as well. You may already see that I have activated Power Oscillator set bonus too, but in fact, we don't really need this set bonus. The thing we need is linking those two item-specific attributes with Sentinel's ability. For example, once you have equipped Column Collector, With Sentinel's energy shield passive ability, you will soon discover that you can almost maintain this immortality as long as you can keep destroying enemies. No one can damage you unless you stop damaging others. The munition motor appears to be less important, I won't deny that, but hey, wouldn't it be fun if we can deliver our lightning gun's power to those enemies around 1.7 kilometers away? We have a saying, 1 inch longer, 1 inch stronger. Meanwhile, the over-penetration catalyst on Enforcer allows us ignore enemies' shields and armor, strictly damage the hull and execute it with the Grim Reaper. And this is proved to be very effective. Okay, now let's turn to a ship with new build and playstyle, Stinger. What we are doing here is utilizing the passive 25% increased corrosion damage and the new consumable secondary resupply to make Stinger as a lightweight corrosive bomber. Thanks to its passive, you can restore 25% booster energy after using a device, and meanwhile, Enforcer and Grim Reaper are not very energy consuming. This means we don't really need the help of energy warps. So say goodbye to Stratocumulus and the Column Collector. Now we have enough place for Blightmonger set bonus 4 and Redemption set bonus 3. You may worry that we have limited ammo. Well, yes and no, because we have brought 2 stacks of secondaries resupply. So this means we have 42 corrosion mines in total without considering its restock attribute. And because we only have 1 secondary slot for the corrosion mine, this limits its fire rate, so good and bad. But anyway, don't worry about the ammo, it's plenty. In short, if you like corrosion mines, but you also like high mobility, I believe this build will work good for you. We all know gunship can deal really high primary DPS, but the gunship build we are going to demonstrate today is a secondary based. The idea is you have 4 primary hardpoints, which means you have doubled retal fire. So if we are using Final Reckoning, it means we can charge the Reckoning effect twice faster. And now we are charging this effect faster so we can bring 2 slots of 0k boomer. The 0k boomer has a relatively longer cooldown time compared with mines, so therefore if you only use one of your 0k boomer during combat, you are certainly kind of wasting the advantage of Reckoning recharge rate. Hope you get what I mean. So one of your boomer is still cooling down, but you have your Reckoning effect ready, make sure you can immediately switch to another boomer and fire it if there are enemies nearby. The Striker is using a similar strategy as Gunship. Yeah, it may be a bit boring, but the Reckoning Boomer combo is just so good. The Coil Turret and the doubled primary weapon hardpoints are Striker lacking of, so we still need to bring a destabilizer missile with us. The advantage of Gunship is the ability to quickly fire 2 Reckoning Boomer. Well, for the Striker, the advantage is you can make use of your passive, special, ultimate, and attributes to make your Reckoning Boomer dealing further doubled damage. How can we do this? The cargo unit attribute, activating missile defense system, increased 25% secondary damage. That's times 1.25. Striker special times up to 1.3. And your ultimate times up to 1.25. And meanwhile, because we are using Quantum Turbo, so we don't need to worry about the cooldown time for the teleporter. This allows us bring 1 slot of secondary resupply. Yes, we have plenty of ammo to waste. Thank you. Vanguard's build almost remains unchanged compared with previous video. I may just skip the commentary section, but there are still two points I'd like to emphasize. The first thing is, it's very up to you whether to use Column Collector or not, because Vanguard's mobility or handling is already crazy enough, because the Column Collector can potentially drop the rare energy ore, which can greatly improve ship's handling, but it is few to no or even negative beneficial for Vanguard, unless you can handle it. The second thing is, currently there is a bug for Catalyst Shield Strike. If you are charging your Enforcer, you can see it will almost immediately deplete your reactive armor. So, if you wish to improve your survivability in high lunacy rifts, you can try to integrate Symbiosis Set Bonus 4 into your build. The Vindicator is still relying on its explosive drones to destroy enemies, so no commentary for this ship. Oh, hang on a second. Did Rockfish Games just fix the ultimate related bug I mentioned in previous video? Hooray! And another good thing is we have a brand new consumable ultimate recharger, and this can perfectly deal with the situation that you wish to trigger a drone explosion but just lacks of a tiny amount of ultimate charge. But anyway, that's enough for Vindicator. It is still not good for Rift's speedrunning, however, a pretty easy ship to beat high lunacy Rift, even you don't have some high quality gears. Again, whether it is a good or bad ship, it's very up to you. Scout is still the fastest light ship to clear the rift. This time we have tweaked the build a little bit. The solo catalyst can bring your weapon with 35% increased damage and fire rate. You may probably ask, is the 35% increased fire rate affect the beam laser? Because from the stats, there is no fire rate value for beam laser. In fact, beam laser does have a fire rate, which is 10 ticks per second, and this fire rate bonus does benefit it. You can strictly fuel it by the energy consumption, by the way. So, this means the solo catalyst can immediately increase your DPS by approximately 82%. Therefore, we no longer need to use a barrage catalyst as well as a vigilante, I don't know my pronunciation, but this set bonus too. And we all know the disintegrator has already been a very energy consumed weapon, and now it is getting worse due to the fire rate increase. To compensate this drawback, we are using power oscillator set bonus too, and make sure we can frequently teleport forward once during combat, which helps the stratocumulus to pull energy orbs for us. To be honest, when I was recording this video, I thought Scout can highly likely to beat Interceptor this time, because compared with Scout, Interceptor didn't get some direct buff in Titan DLC, such as damage bonus on secondary weapons and etc. However, this still didn't happen, as the buff on Interceptor is somehow indirect but still effective. If you still remember the build that have been used in previous video, to maintain a high critical hit chance, I have been used Storm Chaser set bonus 2 to drop more energy orbs. The problem is, you need to equip a Tailwind for this, and I can be very straightforward, this booster sucks. But thankfully, we have Column Collector in Titans DLC. Okay, goodbye Storm Chaser, especially you Tailwind, so we can use a faster booster with a better functionality. Yes, it's you, Quantum Turbo, again. Now, you can see in the past, although Interceptor is a medium ship, the mobility and speed was always a problem. But these new items perfectly solve this matter. And this should be the reason maintains Interceptor still the fastest ship to clear Lunacy 2000 Rifts.